Thursday of the 29th week in Ordinary Time.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, I am speaking in human terms because of the weakness of your nature. For just as you presented the parts of your bodies as slaves to impurity and to lawlessness for lawlessness, so now present them as slaves to righteousness for sanctification. For when you were slaves of sin, you were free from righteousness. But what profit did you get then from the things of which you are now ashamed? For the end of those things is death. But now you have been freed from sin and have become slaves of God. The benefit that you have leads to sanctification, and its end is eternal life. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. The word of the Lord.
The responsorial psalm. The response is, "Blessed are they who hope in the Lord." Blessed the man who follows not the counsel of the wicked, nor walks in the way of sinners, nor sits in the company of the insolent, but delights in the law of the Lord and meditates on his law day and night. Blessed are they who hope in the Lord. He is like a tree planted near running water that yields its fruit in due season and whose leaves never fade. Whatever he does prospers. Blessed are they who hope in the Lord. Not so the wicked, not so. They are like chaff which the wind drives away. For the Lord watches over the way of the just, but the way of the wicked vanishes. Blessed are they who hope in the Lord.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus said to his disciples, "I have come to set the earth on fire, and how I wish it were already blazing. There is a baptism with which I must be baptized, and how great is my strength until it is accomplished. Do you think that I have come to establish peace on the earth? No, I tell you, but rather division. From now on, a household of five will be divided, three against two, and two against three. A father will be divided against his son, and a son against his father. A mother against her daughter, and a daughter against her mother. A mother-in-law against her daughter-in-law, and a daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law." The Gospel of the Lord.
The first reading is from Romans 6, 19 to 23. Paul continues the idea that we have to live a life of righteousness. We have to choose to live in the Spirit, because previously we were slaves to sin. And when we were slaves to sin, we used our bodies in the wrong way. We committed acts which only brought us death and selfishness and loneliness. Now that we've been justified, we have to live a life of sanctification. We have to live in the grace of God, because the wage of sin is death. And again, whether this means spiritual death or physical death, it's not quite clear. But the wage of righteousness is eternal life. As with the gospel yesterday, we hear that there are consequences for our choices. That if we choose love, we can live in love. But if we choose the opposite, sin, then we receive the consequence of our choice. The gospel is from Luke 12, 49 to 53. Jesus says he's come to bring fire upon the earth, not peace, but division. It's not that we divide ourselves from others, but rather they divide themselves from us. Because if we choose a life of love, and if we're exuberant in that love, people will reject us. And therefore, houses will be divided against each other. There will be a time of persecution. There's the old saying, no good deed goes unpunished. If we choose the gospel truth, then we'll be taken for a religious fanatic or for a sap or just for a fool. But if we live that witness powerfully, then we will bring fire to the earth. That our Christianity can't be lukewarm. It has to be intense, fervent. And may God bless us.